Modulation techniques that are used for the generation of the amplitude modulated signal are of two types, square law modulator and switching modulator. In this lecture, we will understand what is a square law modulator and how the square law modulator functions as amplitude modulated signal generator. A square law modulator, which is used for the generation of the amplitude modulated signal, depends on the use of a nonlinear device or a square law device such as diode, which means that if we ignore the higher terms generated by a square law device, the input-output characteristics of the modulator can be represented by a square law. Let us see the circuit diagram for the square law modulator. This is the circuit of the square law modulator. A square law modulator circuit is consist of a modulating or massive signal source, MT, a carrier signal source, or CT, and a nonlinear device or a square law device, and a bandpass filter constructed by using LC tuned circuit. Let us understand the block diagram for a square law modulator. At first, the massive signal and carrier signal are given as an input to the adder circuit, which generate the signal X1T, which is given as an input to the square law device, and square law device generates the output signal X2T, and X2T is given as an input to the bandpass filter, which finally generates the amplitude modulated signal XT. Let us see the mathematical analysis of the square law modulator. Let's say modulating signal or massive signal generated by modulating signal source is equal to MT, and the carrier signal generated by the carrier signal source is equal to CT. From the block diagram, modulating signal and carrier signal are given as the input to the summer. The output of this summer is X1T, and it is the addition of the modulating signal and the carrier signal. So we can write X1T is equal to MT plus CT. If we put the value of carrier signal CT as AC cos 2 pi FCT, then X1T is equal to MT plus AC cos 2 pi FCT. Identify this as equation number 1. Now, as a square law device, we can use either diode or a transistor. Then, the input-output characteristics of a square law device can be given as X2T is equal to A1 into X1T plus A2 into X1T whole square. Identify this as equation number 2. Here, A1 and A2 are constants. Input to this square law device is the output of the summer, which is X1T, and the output of the square law device is X2T. So, according to the characteristics of the square law device, we can write X2T is equal to A1 into X1T plus A2 into X1T square. If we put the value of X1T as MT plus AC cos 2 pi FCT, then X2T can be written as A1 into MT plus A1 AC cos 2 pi FCT plus A2 into MT plus AC cos 2 pi FCT whole square. Now, if we multiply A1 and apply the A plus B whole square formula in the MT plus AC cos 2 pi FCT whole square, then X2T can be written as A1 into MT plus A1 into AC cos 2 pi FCT plus A2 into M square T plus 2MT into AC cos 2 pi FCT plus AC square cos square 2 pi FCT. Now, if we multiply A2 with all the terms inside the second bracket, then X2T is equal to A1 into MT plus A1 into AC cos 2 pi FCT plus A2 into M square T, 2 into A2 into MT into AC cos 2 pi FCT plus A2 into AC square cos square 2 pi FCT. Identify this as equation number 3. Here, A1 into MT is the scaled modulating signal, A1 into AC cos 2 pi FCT is the scaled carrier signal, A2 into M square T is the scaled squared modulating signal, 2 into A2 into MT into AC cos 2 pi FCT is the amplitude modulated signal with the sidebands only, A2 into AC square into cos square 2 pi FCT is the scaled squared carrier signal. Here, desired terms are term 2 and term 4. In order to acquire the desired terms, the output is passed through a bandpass filter, which is constructed with the help of an LC tuned circuit. So, the output of this nonlinear or square law device is given as an input to the LC tuned circuit, which works as a bandpass filter. For this LC tuned circuit, the circuit is tuned to the center frequency FC, and the bandwidth of this circuit is equal to 2 into FM. The frequency response of this circuit can be given by: it has a minimum allowable frequency of minus FM and a maximum allowable frequency of plus FM, which constitutes to the bandwidth of 2 into FM. As the output is passed through bandpass filter, this LC tuned circuit, which is used as the bandpass filter, eliminates the undesired term and only gives required terms as the output. So the output of the bandpass filter can be given by XT is equal to A1 into AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 into into mt into ac cos 2 pi fc t. If we take a1 into ac common from the equation, then it can be written as xt is equal to a1 into ac into cos 2 pi fc t plus 2 into a2 divided by a1 into mt into cos 2 pi fc t. Now, if we take cos 2 pi fct common, then xt is equal to a1 into ac into 1 plus 2 into a2 divided by a1 into mt into cos 2 pi fct, which can be further simplified as xt is equal to a1 into ac into 1 plus ka into mt into cos 2 pi fct. Identify this as equation number 4. Here, ka is the amplitude sensitivity, and the equation for the standard amplitude modulated signal is st is equal to ac into 1 plus k into mt into cos 2 pi fct. If we compare that equation with the equation number 4, then we can say that square law modulator generates the amplitude modulated signal.
That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.